Hey, what's up? This is Jamal Abbott, here to show you an overview of 8x8 Work for Desktop. This video is intended to show you a brief overview of the features and functions of the 8x8 Work for Desktop app. You'll also see some links to some specific videos where I go deeper into each one of these functions. But for today, we're just going to show you what this looks like from a high level. Starting first here, we're at the call screen. We're going to jump up to this profile menu and look at the available options on this screen. So we see my name, my number, and my extension, and I have the option of typing in a status. Just type something in here real quick. Once that status is updated, you see that it's here in this upper left-hand corner, and then any other individuals that are connected with you will see your status message. I can change any one of these status indicators. This is your present status. I can change this from available to do not disturb. Once do not disturb is on, you see that there's a little red icon here with a minus sign, meaning that I do not want to be disturbed. If I want to turn that off, I can simply change that to available. So there's different presence indicators depending upon what you're up to. And this is available to you. And if you don't want to be found online, you can certainly turn this off to invisible, but for this video, we'll leave this on as available. Next is search. Search, you're able to look up contacts. So we'll look up two contacts that I have in my phone system. So this is Ricky. If I click on his information, you will see Ricky's contact information. So messages that I've sent to Ricky, as well as any other relevant information for Ricky. The other contact I'll look up is going to be Nikki. And there's Nikki Jones, the marketing manager for this example. And once again, relevant contact information. So this is how you use the search function for 8x8 Work for Desktop. Moving down here to calls, this is where you would place calls as well as receive calls for your phone system. And once you're presented here to this section, you'll see all of your calls, so the calls made out, as well as any calls received in. You have missed calls towards the top, and then any voicemails. Next, we have contacts. So these are the contacts for the phone system. So I have my contacts for the entire company. So it's just three here. I can have a favorite contact. So if I want to go here, select on Nikki, and then click the star icon here, she now becomes my favorite contact. And then you can also see here, there's a section for my contacts. If you're synced up with Microsoft or even Google, those third-party contacts will appear here and you can make those calls to those individuals from this section. Going down here to messages, this is where you can send SMS messages out to text-enabled phones like your cell phones and whatnot. This also doubles as an instant messaging function for anybody that's within your phone system. So you see here that there's a couple examples of some messages. I have a message here to Nikki Jones. So that was an internal message because this is a similar color to the color scheme to the phone system. If you look at this external message, this is a test message that I sent out to one of my test numbers and then showing that this was sent out in green. This person is external to my phone system, and this individual received my message and sent a picture back. So you can receive pictures, you can receive attachments if they're within your phone system. So this is a pretty versatile tool, and you're able to send messages from the screen. One thing you can also do too is that if you're within this window and you need to escalate the call up to or escalate this message up to a phone call, you can certainly do that by pushing this call button here, which will then
you've reached the Jamal Abbott Show pod,
which will then make that call out to that individual. If we go back to one of my internal contacts, you see that I have an option of calling Nikki Jones as well as escalating this up to a meeting. So if we need to jump into a quick meeting, I can click this button here and then we jump immediately into a meeting. So this brings me to the next section. We'll go ahead and just exit out of this. This is the meetings function, and this is where you can have video chat, as well as audio meetings with anybody within your phone system, as well as other participants outside of your organization. So usually with this, you're going to provide meeting information to those individuals, and they'll be able to call in to that meeting, or if you provide them with a web link, that information can be sent to them and they can join from the web. So a lot of flexibility here with having meetings from this platform. Our next section is facts. So once again, you might be thinking to yourself, why are we talking about facts here, Jamal, in 2021 and maybe beyond if you're looking at this video? Facts may be relevant depending upon your organization, but this platform does have the ability to send out faxes as well as receive them. And if you want to do that, you simply just go here to this fax section, you click on that, and then this gives you a log of your faxes that have been sent or received. If I want to send a fax out, I simply click here, and then I'm presented with this menu, which will give you some details about the fax that you want to send. And then if I need to drop an attachment, I simply click here to drop an attachment, as well as then just send it off once that's all said and done. This next section here is for call recordings. Now, depending upon your settings for your phone system, this may or may not be an available feature to you. But if you happen to be on the phone call and you need to record a phone call, this gives you the ability to do that. So depending on your setup, and then depending upon the regulations in your local area, this may or may not be an option for you. But if you do need to record phone calls, you can certainly do that, and this will appear here in the section for call recordings. This next section here is the call using. We talked about this in the another video that I'll link to. And this gives you the ability to switch between your computer for making phone calls or an associated desk phone. So depending upon what you need to make the call for, you can certainly switch between the two or use one of these as your primary function for making that phone call. This next section here, we'll have to do another video on this here in the near future. This is for pairing a room and sharing your screen. So 8x8 has this thing called Spaces, and this gives you the ability to meet in a conference room and then share your information to a conference room screen, and that will allow you to share content as well as any other pertinent details for participants in a conference room. This last section here is for settings, and this is where I can adjust the settings for the app. So anything from audio to video to notifications, look and feel. Let's just go to look and feel here real quick, and you can see here that I can change the color of this app depending upon the color scheme that I want to use. So I like the dark scheme. This is something that's new, and I'm just going to go ahead and go with that. But lots of settings here, and it's just up to you on what you need to adjust. And speaking of settings, let me go back to one more section. So voicemail setup and call forwarding, these are all in this profile menu here. So we're going to go ahead and click voicemail setup, and then from this screen you'll see that you're logged into the web page, and then you have some options for changing your voicemail greeting. So you can set a voicemail greeting for external parties, so that's anybody that is calling from outside of your phone system and then getting your voicemail message. You can leave a custom message specifically for them. You can also have an internal voicemail greeting, and that would be for people within your organization who may not be able to reach you. Then you also have the option here of resetting your voicemail PIN, as well as setting a custom zero dial out option. So if you were to click that, you can choose a target. So, and let's just say that I want to send this phone call to Nikki Jones. So anytime that somebody pushes zero on my voicemail message, they will be routed directly to Nikki Jones, and then she may be able to help that person at that point in time. The other thing about this too is that you may want to say on your voicemail message that, hey, please press zero to reach somebody that can help you. So that option is available to you. The other option that we'll look at is going to be call forwarding. So from here, we have the ability to forward calls to another individual. And we can also change how we're routing calls based upon our current status. So for instance, if I'm busy, I can have this call go directly to voicemail. I can have it go to no one and play busy, or I can have this forward directly to another contact or extension. So you have a lot of flexibility here when it comes to how your calls are being managed. Let's just say that you want to forward all calls. So I might be out of the office. I don't want to be bothered, but I do want somebody to cover for me. And I can go here to this forward all calls option. We'll click this pencil here. And then we can either have this go directly to voicemail or send this to a selected user or service. So if I click on that, we can see that we have some options that we can choose from. So another thing here I just noticed up here at the top is another option for adding a rule. So we'll go ahead and click on that. And it looks like we can set up a custom rule. So that's good to know. We have some custom call handling functions here. So I specify a name here, and then I can select the condition for when this rule would apply. You can apply to anybody, anonymous callers or selected callers. And then you can see here too, there's some radio buttons to choose from. We can choose the time that this needs to happen. So this could be any time. We can have this go for a specific time and date, or we can have this going on a recurring schedule. So just kind of like if you need to maybe set up a condition where you're reachable on your phone between the hours of 8 and 5, Monday through Friday, and then anything after that is going to go to some other place, like maybe voicemail or maybe to another person. So you have some call handling functionality here in this call forward rules section. Looks like that is it for our video. So we have 8x8 Work for Desktop. Nice little overview of what we have here as far as features and functionalities. Please let me know if there's any questions. If you want to find more information about any one of these features that we've discussed, please check out the links below. And if there's any questions, let me know. Would love to help you out or answer anything that I may have missed in this video. So this is Jamal Abbott. Thanks again for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.